Okay, hi. First thing you'll notice, or maybe you won't until somebody says something, I officially have Streamlabs and it's working. And so chat will appear on screen, which is awesome. I'm gonna take the stream info real quick because it's not entirely accurate, or if I mean it's completely inaccurate. So, but basically, don't sew together. It's not happening again. I'm really sorry about that. What is that warning? Okay, dropped frames. Okay. Yeah, this software, I'm getting used to it, so it's gonna be a little bit fiddly. But essentially, in the future, when Don't Sew Together is cancelled, I'll play like random games. Well, not completely random. I got that Humble Bundle for racial justice and equality a few months ago, and I downloaded some game from that, and that's what's up on my screen right now. In addition, there's the I have Lego Star Wars on my computer. I have Slime Rancher. Wait, is that on my account or is it on the family account? I can't use the family account, turns out. It's not a great idea to have a family account for Steam because, you know, they only let one person use stuff on that account at a time. Okay, so I have Slime Rancher. I'm rambling a bit, sorry. The point is that some of the games I have I can't play all the time because they're on like the communal account and as I get money I buy them and get them for my private account, but whatever. And future. There we go. Update information. Okay. Information is updated. But anyway, what do you what do you want to see me play? I was gonna play Alice, Madison Jones, or American McGee's Alice. Those are one of the ones that's on the family account, and it's gonna be a pain in the butt buying them because they're not actually available on Steam anymore. But so I got the Humble Bundle, for racial justice and equality, and all of that is on the screen now. I also have Flashpoint, and if you don't know what Flashpoint is, you should. It's hang on. It's basically a collection of like 200,000 Flash games that were saved before Flash stopped being what's it called? It before Flash started before Flash lost compatibility with browsers and stuff. So, let's see. Games, all games. Nope, that is the wrong thing. Okay. Yeah, like I said, I'm getting used to Streamlabs. So there's the stuff on the bundle for racial justice and equality. And then okay. Dropped frames. Okay, I don't know what that means. I'm guessing it means that something bad. I've got a viewer. Are you saying anything bad? Is it like really laggy? Is it dysfunctional? Can you hear me? But yeah, in the future, stuff's gonna pop up on screen for y'all, which will be great. So that's the thing. You know what? I think I might just play Lego Star Wars if that's okay with all of you. I'll make a new. Do I want to remove window capsule? Yeah. So it's gonna be a black screen for a bit. That's fine. It just means that I am working on getting Lego Star Wars set up. Because I might as well play it. Starting next week, I can have Lego Batman 2. Not Lego Batman 2, Lego Batman as well. Okay, let me... Okay, so game capture, getting it set up. New game capture and source. Looking for a game to capture. Yes, Lego Star Wars The Complete Saga. That is that is what I'll be doing for the next hour and a half, I guess. And I'll update the stream thing. I'm kind of terrible at controllers, I'll be honest. But let's do a new game. There we go. Alright. I remember playing. I was very young when I played this on an Xbox. God, I haven't seen the movies in a long time, and it's been really a lot longer since I've seen the prequels because, you know, I don't rewatch the prequels with any frequency whatsoever. Although I've seen The Mandalorian, I saw the first of the Disney trilogy, which I forgot what that one was called, and then I saw Rogue One, and then I saw both. I did hear that it got less good after that, which is why I stopped. Which is why I stopped watching it. Blah blah. I think people are familiar with the Star Wars plot. I think honestly, if you see a lot of memes, it can be possible to reverse interview what happened in the Star Wars based on memes. I did that with an old arcade game called Gauntlet. I've never played it because, you know, it's an arcade game. I've never been to a video game arcade because they're not really around anymore. And I kind of was forced to hear how the game works based on memes around it. So that was fun. Okay, see? That bit always cracks me up, like the opening scene, because why do I not have a lightsaber? Oh, that's right. Okay.
to get by taking all of the money possible out of everything, which is hilarious to me. But yeah, let's see where this goes. Let's see how far I can get on Lego Star Wars into Owls. Lego Star Wars, the Complete Saga is on Nexus, by the way. And I know because I looked and I want to see what kind of mods they were. And there is a mod that changes the music in the campaign there to the guest is never going to give you up, which I think is hilarious. And yeah, but good to see you. And I'm going to be all over the place. If anybody new is watching this because I haven't really played anything like Lego Star Wars before, yeah, I'm going to be all over the place because I always am. But on March 20th, my favorite band of all time, Persona and Bluebox, is doing a stay-at-home concert, which is going to be awesome, and I'm going to watch it. And I know that, like, okay, I'm a fairly introverted person, and the last concert I saw was a Doodlebox concert. So, around that time is when I last went to a concert, so I didn't really get the appeal. And I saw some posts, I'm not kidding, I literally saw like those humans of weirdos on Tumblr, one of them was talking about like the joys of a concert, and I'm like, that sounds pretty cool, I'd like to do that. And, you know, done COVID. So that didn't happen, as it turns out, which is unfortunate, but... yeah, I'm gonna go to a concert when this is over, I hope. When this is over, I say, geez, don't mean to be a bummer, but I'm just kind of... Today marks 1 year since the first confirmed case of COVID in the United States. So, yeah, and I think next week is when spring break was. My university canceled spring break because they don't really want us going places and getting disease, apparently. So they're completely canceled it, and we have like meeting days instead. But I think that next week is when we have spring break, and oh, okay. So it was vile checking my email because I'm like, okay, so I know COVID's spreading a lot. So let me see what my university has to say about it. And over the week, there's this progression. They were like, okay, well, we're going to delay going back to school for about half a week to see when the, to figure out what to do. And I'm like, huh, all right. And then a day or two later, they're like, okay, we'll be going online for 2 weeks, and then we'll be going back to school. And I'm like, I don't like the sound of that. And then the next day, they're like, forget going back in person. We are not doing that this semester, which, you know, had to be done because, you know, the thing. But at the same time, kind of, frustrating. Because I want to be in person, and I'll be honest, especially in college, I don't know what it's like in the grades, but with college, it feels like we're expected to do the same amount of education and stuff, and we are also entirely on our own, and it's a nightmare, and... You know, if it won't, then I'm not, like, saying, oh, I want to be back in school right now. I mean, I do, but I also don't want to get COVID and get other people sick with COVID and stuff like that. So I don't actually want, like, I want to in the abstract, but in reality, when you take into account everything else that would happen if I did, I don't want to. But it's just, it's not, it's kind of a nightmare. It's, that's kind of a bummer, so I'm gonna talk about Post Rod and Jukebox instead, because like I said, they are my favorite band of, like, all time, because they do all the sorts of stuff. There's like dozens of musicians, and they're not all playing at once. It's like a rotating band because some they do covers of songs in like different genres. So they have like a they've got a soul cover of Don't Stop Me Now, which is pretty cool. They've got Bioshock Infinite World's cover of Worlds of Fun Have Fun. They've got hundreds of songs and they're all excellent. And they're gonna do a concert on the 20th again, and I'm going to listen to it. And yeah, I'm just super excited for that. But let's see. Is the force? Oh, I already have two, did I? Oops. And yeah, it's impossible to get all of the minifigures until you do free play mode. Yep, see? That's not happening. Even though I totally could have jumped up there. If not for the force field. Okay. I'm talking at like a million miles a minute, and I can't really control that. So I hope you can understand me. And, nope. There is no R2-D2 or droid-like R2-D2. I don't know what they're called. The ones like this. It's just... So I feel like this is one of those games, you know, it's a lot better if you do it co-op, but I don't think anybody's available to do it co-op with me. And it's, yeah, but let me get this. Oh, you can't break that, which is actually surprising because you can. Oh, that's cool. You know, you gotta be like Jojo Binks or somebody to get in. Yeah, you gotta be Jojo Binks. Which is not something that's ever said in the original Star Trek, I believe. So a lot of games from this year were the graphics kind of delayed super bad, and even from later year was, but I guess it one of the cool things about Lego Star Wars is that it's effectively immortal. I mean, they're Legos. They look kind of cartoony and stuff, but they're Legos. They're just, you know, it's not gonna be like, oh well, you know, these Legos don't look like Legos anymore. Although that's another one on Nexus, apparently. They make it so that the minifigures, is so that every single character, the Lego characters, they look like the kind of stuff Legos produce in the day, which is really cool, and I admire people who have the diligence to do stuff like that. Figure on the bottom. That's how gravity works. There we go. And I'm gonna get that minifigure. I might as well get as many as possible this time around. I mean, for one thing. Okay, looks like I might not be able to get this. And I did a backwards flip, which is cool, but probably not super useful. So, let's see. Yes, cutscene, thank you. Oh, they're not shooting every little cutscene, that's good. Sorry, I play a lot of Bethesda, so I'm used to being attacked in those little, like, cutscene thingies. Like the time the Choreo and Skyrim absolutely had to give me a message right this second, and there was literally a dragon attacking, and I'm like, anyway, just a second, my dude. And I couldn't, but there we go. So let's see what happens if I do the level. Nope, it's broken. Okay. But I can break these and get my health back. There we go. The complete collection is on Steam now, which is, you know, cool. Up in another one. How many things are difficult in this game? It was a lot more difficult than I was. But the vehicle things, that is one thing. Okay. I was gonna say that the vehicle is in Lego Star Wars Infinity, the vehicle that holds in the 8 very well. But one thing I found is that a lot of video games, the vehicle mechanics are not great. So, yeah. See, I got stream. Let's see you. And, I'm going to be listening for the follower noise. Do follow on the subscription noise, but I can't actually see it. It's not on my screen. It's just added during the upload, I guess. Yep. When you get all the money, you become a true Jedi, because that is what Jediism is all about. There we go. Jeez, okay, yeah, sure. Sorry about that, something weird happened. And, I am really sorry, I didn't realize that the screen was like that. So I'm gonna go fix that real quick. I didn't realize this. I'm sorry. In the future, God, that is not great. So let me put this below video capture. There we go. So that's as good as it's gonna get, unfortunately, in terms of. Well, if I do this, there we go. Is that better? I think that's better. Hang on. Okay, I just wanted to make sure that it wasn't going to block off my screen or anything. So, okay. Let's continue the story. Here we go. Things that use in this game. right here. Here they go. There we go. Let me grab these. And by only bounty hunters who access these days, they mean, yep, that one. Destroy that. Yeah, I think there's no way to get that without dying. Oh. Obviously. Okay. If you want to be reasonable about it, it's not so clear that as a forced impulse. Oh boy. You gotta be a bounty hunter to do that, to get past that. To get up here. Here we go. Well, I should probably turn into somebody with combat capabilities. Thank you. into the bottle, I guess. Okay, I just wanted to be honest with that because, like I said, I don't actually rewatch the peak. I've seen the peak for this once. So, I wanted to get more familiar with what was going on. Because this is, the abridged version of the plot. Okay, that's the thing about this game, like, the graphics were never intended to be good, and as such, they will never become so, they will never get, like, so up to need as to be unplayable. And it's always been good to me, it's always gonna be good to me, and, you know, that's the thing I like about this, actually. Get all the money off this. And these things I can't destroy without the help of a Jedi. And the Jedi left to do something. But I can blow those up. There we go. I think we're on track for true Jedi at this point, unless I die a bunch. But what are the odds of that happening? Okay. Good, good, standing good. Okay, good to see. See what else here. Nothing. Okay. On her hips, like swaying, snapping animation. Which, okay, I don't mind for her so much because she's like a, she's a queen, she's not really a combat person. I have a little bit more of a bond with that when we get to have Princess Leia. She has like the exact same animation. And she's sort of like a rebel leader or whatever. Well, no, she is a rebel leader, just absolutely, that is the thing that she is. So, it doesn't really make sense for her to do that. Okay, let's see. But, oh well, there we go. And, you know, I'm not saying how dare this game, because it was made in 2005, and the 2005s were a time, well, no, it was made before 2005, because I played it in 2005. And I barely play video games as soon as they come out. I'm sure any long-time watchers of my stream have noticed this. I tend to play games late, but... Ah, we're not supposed to do this because we are not Jedi. Okay. have no way to block, so that's always a problem. Oh, so these ones I cannot see. And that I might as well not use the force at that point. Okay. A little bit because I'm pretty sure that there was some more money up there and yeah. quality. You have to be a kid to get that, I think. Mean that that's the one that makes you progress, so let's hit that one last. Close. That's not a very comfy landing, I'll be honest.
Into this game.
certain levels. Require a lot of help, but I didn't mean to skip that info, but yeah, now we're on the first planet. And I think we're asking these people for help, the Nabu. Are they the Nabu? I think they're the Nabu. There we go. now I can help.
Do that when I have somebody who can double jump up there because that was getting annoying, and I'm sure it was annoying for you too. So let's see. It cannot be destroyed. Here we go, 1 out of 10. And put that on for 30 studs. Oh, that's a buff medal.
Boom, 2 out of 10. Everybody can officially get a boss. Things, which means I can't get that coin. Okay. You know, the first time I started doing Magnus again, the complete lack of ability to control the tower in gold annoyed me. It isn't so much anymore though, because really need to. It's really good at telling where you're supposed to be looking, honestly. Is that a leg spike in Lego Star Wars again? Okay.
Nope.
Yeah, but they didn't want to, like, throw it in or they're dodging and stuff. But maybe they can, because this is a very old game. I'm just saying they didn't feel like because I play a lot of the Bethesda games. So,
TD2.
Also, I don't think I slept. Well, I must have slept for a little bit last night, but I didn't sleep for long, like, at all. So, oops. As long as you're playing them, I should say. Yeah. But you have to be on 2D to get across that. There we go. Oh, so that was literally just for 2D to get up there. Okay, that makes sense. This way. Go ahead over here again. There we go. Actually, sure. If OTD2 can make it all the way across, I'm on the way back, and I want to be safe. So. Okay, so these you actually can only use the force on. Because when it's an ass level, you didn't have to use the force.
Out.
Okay, he doesn't have a blast still. Yep, that's a replay only thing. Okay. So Neki have been jump up the stairs in this game. So she'll let the rolling droids. you.
Funny, I can't get to. Okay. Alright, we got to Jedi. There we go. Okay. What do I do with this? Just shake it a bit, okay. Signing off for the day, and that will bring us to about 5 o'clock. So that's another one. And like I said, let's get back to unlock characters and stuff. Can I do that to you? I cannot. I gotta go back.
divide them in a line because there's no sword function. I'm gonna quit. And that's it. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, feel free to subscribe. Don't follow me. And this is gonna be a thing from now on. Whenever neither, assuming I haven't had a test that day, if neither of my friends can make it to themselves together, I'm gonna be doing. For now, Lego Star Wars. After that, I don't know. Whatever. So, that's it. Have fun. Stay safe.